हेलो हेलो, गुड डे ऑल ऑफ यू। वेलकम टू आवर सेशन, वेलकम टू आवर चैनल इंटेलिजिबल ट्यूटोरियल्स। इन दिस पर्टिकुलर सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट द नैवी बेस्ड क्लासिफिकेशन एल्गोरिथम। एक्चुअली दिस नैवी बेस्ड क्लासिफिकेशन एल्गोरिथम इज ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड इन आवर प्रीवियस वीडियोस, बट हियर माय इंटेंशन इज आई वांट टू डिस्क्राइब इट विद द हेल्प ऑफ वन एग्जांपल। सो द एक्सप्लेनेटरी एग्जांपल इज क्लियरली गिवन इन दिस वीडियो, प्लीज वॉच। Let us see the introduction of the Navibase algorithm. As we all of you know, it's a supervised learning algorithm used for classification types of the problems. It is one kind of the classification. Obviously, classification is obviously comes under the supervised learning. And one more thing here we need to discuss is it's a classification and as well as it is statistical learning, because it implements the probability theory for classification, and hence it is also called as probabilistic classifier. Here the prediction of the each and every data item is based on its probability. We have to calculate the probability of each and every data item to predict. Okay, so this is one of the important feature of this. One more important characteristic of this Navibase algorithm is here the features are independent. Whatever features are there, feature means what? In a data set, a feature is actually an attribute. So the features are independent of each other. Normally the attributes or the features, one is dependent on another and some are relevant. But in this case of Navibase algorithm, the features are irrelevant and the features are not related to each other. So this is some important characteristic of this Navibase algorithm. So we see what are the various kinds of the applications. Navibase algorithm basically used for the text classification only, and for document classification and high dimensional text classification, obviously we may choose this algorithm for classification. Navibase is the best one for the text classification. And what are the various advantages? The first advantage is it is very fast and very efficient text classification. And for high dimensional text, it's very good for classifying, which classifies in a fast and efficient manner. So this is one advantage. Now coming to the negative ends, it is also having some negative ends also apart from positive ends. So what are the negative ends is, as the data set is small or tiny, it works well. Because the number of the data items are very few, we can easily calculate the probabilities of each and every data set. Okay, probabilities of each and every data items in the data set. But as the number of the data items grow, the data set becomes bigger. What about the case? In such case, we have to calculate for each and every data item the post probability and priori probability, and each and everything we need to calculate, which leads to more consumption of the space, more consumption of the time, and more consumption of the computations, which increases the complexity of the implementation in the algorithm. Okay, so hence, as the data set grows, it results the more space, time, and computational complexities. Hence, as the data set is tiny or small, it works efficient, but as it grows, it exhibits some kind of complexity. That is one negative end. The another negative end is, previously we discussed, it is one of the characteristic that the features of the Navibase algorithm are independent and as well as the irrelevant. This is one of the drawback. There is no relevance among the attributes is one of the drawback in the Navibase algorithm. So we have seen so far various positive ends and as well as negative ends of this. Next, what is the calculation formula for the Navibase probability is given. Probability of A by B is equal to probability of B by A into probability of A by probability of B. Where probability of A by B is given as the hypothesis A on evidence B. Whereas B by A is given as evidence at which the hypothesis is true. Whereas probability of A is before observing the evidence, whereas probability of B is nothing but a marginal probability, or we can say it as an evidence. Okay, so this is the description of the calculation part of the Navibase probability. Next, we will explain this Navibase probability with the help of a data set. Let us see, this is a data set where it can have two number of the features, weather and play. So here what we need to predict is, based on this data set, we have to predict whether the player can play the game or not. Why he can play the game, why he can't play the game means, if at all it is a sunny day, then only he can play the game. If at all it is either rainy or overcast, he cannot play the game. So we have to predict whether it is a sunny, we are going to predict the sunny attribute here, whether it is yes, sunny is equal to S means yes, it is sunny, the player can play the game. Whether it is no, the player cannot play the game. This we can see exemplary with the exemplary explanation of this particular data set. The data set name is the weather data set, and having the 0 to 13 means total 14 number of the rows, and having the two attributes, weather and play attributes. Weather having three number of the values, rainy, sunny and overcast. And play is a Boolean attribute. It can have either yes or no. Now we start the calculation how we can predict whether it is a sunny, rainy or overcast with the help of this Navibase algorithm. Okay. Before going to that, we will construct a frequency table. Based on this data set, total number of the 14 rows, we will construct a frequency table. This frequency table based on weather feature. We are constructing it here based on this particular feature only. So that is weather feature. Now see, in this weather feature, overcast. Overcast is equal to S having value and as well as no also having the values. How many values of S, how many values, for each and every variable, for each and every value can have S data and as well as the no data. So how we can see, we can see. See, overcast S 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Overcast at S, total 5. So overcast at no, there are no attributes, zero attributes for overcast no. So hence it is 0. Now coming to the sunny, there are three attributes, sunny S, 2 and 3. So here 3 I have written. Next, sunny no, how many number of attributes? Sunny no 1, sunny no 2 number of the attributes. Now coming to the rainy, rainy S1, rainy S2. Okay, so rainy S2 and as well as rainy no also 2, we have 1 and 2. Like that we have 2 number of S, 2 number of rows. Now total number of S based on all the values is 10 and total number of no's based on all the values is 4. What is the total number of rows actually? 0 to 13, that is 14. Total number of S rows 10, total number of no rows is 4 based on this calculation. So this is based on the frequency table we constructed based on weather feature. Now we go for the likelihood table. For this likelihood table, again these values are same. We copied it from the previous table. This weather, S, no, overcast values, S values and no values here we have calculated. But we calculated one new term called likelihood here. This likelihood, what it is saying is, for the overcast, the likelihood is total S plus no by total no's, total rows. Total S, 5 plus 0, total no, 0 by 14. 5 by 14, that is 0.35. Similarly, sunny, total S, total no, 3 comma 2, 3 plus 2, 5 by 14, 0.35. In the same manner, rainy also, 2 plus 2, total S, 2, total no, 2, so by 14, 4 by 14, 0.29. So these are the likelihood of each and individual values. Now we see for S or no, the likelihood of S or no. Total S by total rows, total no by total rows. Total S means what? 8 plus 2, 10. 10 by 14, that is 0.71. Total no means 4 by 14, that is 0.29. We have calculated the likelihood of each and every variable like this. And next we go for directly the formula. Probability of Y by S is equal to probability of S by Y into probability of Y by probability of S. Probability of S is, we have already calculated here, probability of sunny, likelihood of sunny, that is 0.35, I have written here. Next, probability of S is nothing but likelihood of S. So what is the value of the likelihood of S here? 0.71 we got. So I have written 0.71. Probability of S by Y, That means total probability of total sunny by probability of total S. What is the probability of total sunny? Probability of total sunny. Yes. That is 3. See, probability of total S, 3. So, 3. Total S. Probability of total S. That is 5 plus 3 plus 2. That is 10. So, sunny S is 3. Total S is 10. So, hence it is 3 by 10. Now, we are calculating the formula. Probability of 3 into 0.71 by 0.35. We got 0.6. Hence, the probability of sunny on S value is 0.6. In the same manner, we are going to construct the no attribute. Same formula, probability of N by S. Instead of S, we are using no here. Okay. So, probability of sunny is obviously 0.35. Now, probability of no. What is the value of the probability of no here? We have 0.29. So, it is 0.29. Okay. So, total probability of total sunny, probability of total no. So, what is the probability of total sunny? 3. Probability of total no is 2. Okay. So, 2. Probability of total no is 4. That is. Okay. So, 2 by 4. That is 0.5. Okay. So, next. Probability of N by S according to this formula, 0.5 into 0.29 by 0.35, that is 0.4. Hence, the probability of the sunny on no attribute we have 0.4. So, whereas S attribute in the previous slide we got 0.6, here we have 0.4. Hence, we can conclude it's a sunny day because its value is bigger. We can conclude that it's a sunny day. A player can play the game based on this. Based on this calculation, we have concluded like this. Okay. So, here one small mistake is there. Instead of no, I have written S here. And probability of yes, instead of no, I have written S here. Please don't confuse. It is no attribute actually. This calculation is based on probability of no attribute. Whereas here, this calculation is based on S attribute. Okay. So, in this way, we can conclude that implement the Navier-Bayes theorem for the probability of the S attribute and no attribute. We got S value as a higher than the no attribute. Hence, we can conclude the player can play the game. Okay. So, this is the exemplary explanation of the Navier-Bayes attribute. If you like this video, please subscribe our Intelligible Tutorials channel. Thank you.